Well, the Brooklyn neighborhood has a long history of advocating for light rail for our community, and we're really excited that the Portland-Milwaukee light rail is finally underway. In the 1890s, one of the country's first interurban electric railways was built through our neighborhood, linking Portland to Oregon City. And in the early 1970s, the Brooklyn Action Corps successfully fought construction of the Mount Hood Freeway, which would have placed a congested freeway down Division Street and cost Portland 1% of its housing stock. The Brooklyn Action Corps also helped transfer that money to later be used for the city's first MAX line. And now our long-awaited plans are finally underway to extend MAX through our neighborhood to Milwaukee. We'll be saying goodbye to a few beloved businesses here in our neighborhood, and we'll be putting up with a little bit of construction over the next few years, but we're really excited about the fresh new face coming to Southeast 17th Avenue and the new opportunities for transit-oriented businesses to find a home along the alignment. And the new MAX amenities will include two new stations, some really cool public art installations, and improved pedestrian and bike access to downtown. Not only will we be able to enjoy a comfortable, petroleum-free new way to get to everything we love in both downtown Portland and Milwaukee, a federal quiet zone agreement that we successfully fought for will bring us much-needed relief from the freight train horns that we have been rattling our windows and waking us up in the wee hours for as long as we can remember. So thanks for investing in our neighborhood, everyone, and it's my great pleasure to introduce our Mayor Sam Adams.
Well, I told Administrator Rogoff that if he would approve the full funding grant agreement, that I would shave my head. So there I am. No, not really. This is for St. Baldrick's for Children's Cancer. I am really thrilled to be here. This is a promise made to South Portland decades ago, and to be able to be part of the team that delivers it, I am thrilled. Thank you, Administrator. We really appreciate it. This has definitely been a public-private, federal government, state, county, city agreement, and it is needed. South Portland is the most congested. It is our most challenged part of the city and region in terms of ease of getting around. It is also one of the parts of the city and parts of the region that experiences some of the highest crashes in terms of pedestrian, automobile, and bikes. This will help. This will relieve the congestion. It is on its own roadway, it's on its own right-of-way, and it will be the most reliable trip time to get to and from South Portland to the rest of the region. In closing, I just want to thank all the businesses along the way that worked with us. I want a special shout out to PECO, which is a major manufacturer along the way that has worked with us. It's a supplier to Boeing. Hundreds of jobs are there. I want to thank TriMet. Neil McFarlane and his team have been great to work with. Everyone else along the way. It's a great day for South Portland. It's a great day for the region. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mayor Adams. This is a great day. It's a big day for me. A lot of us have been on a long ride to get to this point, and I want to thank all the partners, and I'll be a little more descriptive about it as we go through these remarks. We chose to have this event here in the Brooklyn neighborhood because actually, if these walls weren't on the tent, you could see two light rail stations from this particular location. It's going to become one of the most accessible places in our city. And it's going to be a great addition for the whole Brooklyn neighborhood, which TriMet's been a part of since the very beginning. I wanted to, it's my honor actually, to recognize a few of our local elected officials and representatives here. I wanted to just note John Valley from Senator Merkley's office. John. Mickey Blizzard from Congressman Earl Blumenauer's office. I saw Mickey. Congressman Blumenauer was going to be here. He had a last-minute cancellation. Allison Craig from Kurt Schrader's office. I think Representative Dave Hunt is here. I didn't have a chance to shake his hand. One of our TriMet board members, Dr. T. Allen Bethel, is here. Thank you, Dr. Bethel, for being here. I wanted, to recognize Washington County Chair Andy Dyke. Thank you, Andy, for being here. One of the key champions of the project represented Carolyn Tomei from the Milwaukee area. Metro Councilor Shirley Craddock. Clackamas County Commissioner Jim Bernard. From the UPR, from the Union Pacific Railroad, I think Brock Nelson is here. So thank you, Brock. Everybody's name. If there's other elected officials, so raise your hand and acknowledge you. Yeah, thank you very much all for being here. Yeah, Ann Leininger from Clackamas County. We are here today because there really, as the mayor noted, there's one principle about this region that really stands it apart from all others, and it is we are committed to partnerships. We come together. We work together and we make things happen. And this project is indeed one of the great outcomes of that view of the world. FTA has been one of those key partners who have really helped us with all of our projects, but none more than this project. Our local partners, at many steps of the way, had many challenges to overcome, including all the challenges of funding the local share. But we came together, we worked together, we said we can get this done, and we are getting it done. Congratulations to everybody. That includes the City of Portland, the Oregon Legislature and our Governor, ODOT, Metro, Clackamas County, and the City of Milwaukee. We're all partners in this project and we've all made it happen. We should all be very proud of our efforts and what we're doing for our citizens in behalf of our community. Let's give a very warm, sunny Portland welcome to one of our special guests, a real champion of our city and our region. That's FTA Administrator Peter Rogoff.
Thank you very much. I've got to tell you that as I've been privileged to travel around the country as President Obama and Secretary LaHood's emissary in supporting public transit investments across the country, I have been to events with roller girls. I've been to events with live pythons. This is my first ukulele orchestra. So, let's thank the ukulele orchestra. Congratulations really is owed to so many people, Mayor Adams, the whole TriMet community, all of the locally elected and appointed leaders of the counties. I am really thrilled to be here on behalf of President Obama to celebrate Portland's future and really their continuing efforts to be a leading 21st century city when it comes to mobility and opportunities for job growth. I especially want to thank our congressional partners, Senator Merkley, Senator Wyden, obviously, leaders in the Oregon delegation like Peter DeFazio and Earl Blumenauer and Kurt Schrader, and I'll, at the end of my remarks, I'll introduce the newest transportation leader in the House of Representatives. But they together have really not only just been leaders for this region, but leaders for the nation, and I owe them a huge debt of gratitude for making sure that transit is part of that national solution. Areas of Portland and Milwaukee are going to grow 1 million people in the next 20 years. The United States of America is going to grow some 100 million people in the next 30 to 40 years. And the issue that's really before us about is whether we're going to plan for this growth or be overwhelmed by this growth. If Portland continues to plan for this growth, that's what this rail project is about. And that's why the Obama administration is thrilled to partner with you. That's why I'm here to sign a $1.5 billion full funding grant agreement to get TriMet down to Milwaukee. The Obama administration is thrilled to partner on this project because it's going to create thousands of jobs now. It's going to create the infrastructure for continued growth and even more jobs in the future. It's going to mean cleaner air for not just us, for our kids and our kids' kids. And importantly, now more than ever, it's going to mean that families are going to endure less pain at the gas pump. On our drive over here today, we saw $4.29 gasoline. Importantly, President Obama has an all-of-the-above strategy when it comes to dealing with gas prices. It includes more oil and gas exploration. It includes more investment in wind and solar power. But an important part of it is investments like these, giving more families a reliable and desirable transit choice that's going to help them save thousands of dollars a year and keep more of their paycheck in their wallet rather than hand it over at the gas pump. When you think about it, even if just one member of a working family household can take transit because that commute works for them, it's not going to work for everybody, it's not going to work for everyone's commute, but if just one member of the household can take transit on a daily basis, it's going to save thousands of dollars. It's also going to be a benefit to all the highway users, because the more people we can put on that reliable transit option, the less congested the roads are, the less gas the highway users are going to consume, and the more money they're going to save. So this project is really a win-win-win for the whole greater Oregonian community. This is a great opportunity for the Obama administration to partner with you on a project that's really going to improve the quality of life of so many Oregonians by returning Oregonians' tax money back to Oregon. So thank you. Let me also explain one other reason why this is a win-win-win project. One of the wins really has to do with a federal process by which I have to work with my other federal partners, whether it's Congress, the Office of Management and Budget, and the Executive Office of the President, the Treasury Department, Secretary LaHood's office, so many stakeholders. This project has given me the opportunity to teach all of them the correct way to spell Milwaukee. Let me also just say, on a personal note, all of my parents and my grandparents all hail from Brooklyn, but they don't sound like the people around here. So, it's great to be back to Brooklyn. It rains there too. Really, more importantly, I need to ask for your favor, a favor of you for one other critically important thing. As everyone knows, times in Washington have been very polarized. They've been very difficult to make real progress on so many of the things that we need to do as a nation to make progress, not just in creating jobs, but in also seeing to it that our kids have a better future. Right now, we have in conference between a bipartisan, comprehensive transportation bill. We have in conference between the House and the Senate, a Senate-passed bipartisan transportation bill that looks out for the needs of our highways, looks out for the needs of transit, and was done the right way. It had Democrats and Republicans joining together, leaders as diverse as Barbara Boxer and Jim Inhofe coming together on legislation to move our nation forward in job creation and mobility. We need a bill and we need it now. We need it to create jobs now. The Obama administration has been calling on Congress to do this for over 3 years. We put forward many proposals. We need action, and we need action now, or investments like this are not going to be able to be advanced not only elsewhere around Oregon, but elsewhere around the United States. We just need people to put down their partisan fire and do what's right for the United States. We need your help in convincing all stakeholders to urge their legislators to do that. Let me introduce someone who already knows that. A legislative leader who voted for this project back when she was in the state legislature. We're thrilled to have Susan Bonamici in the House of Representatives, and we need more like her. to advance common sense on things that work for the people. So let me introduce the newest member of your delegation, also the newest transportation leader in the House, Susan Bonamici.
Administrator Roga, for that very kind introduction. I'm just thrilled to be here today. Even though it's not in my district, I want to be here to be so supportive and celebrate this really important step toward completion of the Portland-Milwaukee light rail line. And today is one of those days where we can all say we're proud to be Oregonians. Now, 5 years ago, as the administrator said, I was a state legislator and I voted to dedicate $250 million in state lottery funds toward this project, providing the critical boost to get it off the ground. And I'm now proud to be able to support the Department of Transportation and the Federal Transit Administration as they work to modernize our transportation infrastructure here in Oregon and around the nation while creating hundreds of good jobs. And I'm glad the administrator mentioned the transportation bill, which we absolutely need to get passed to create those jobs, to build our infrastructure. And we want a transportation bill that includes transit. And we're fortunate to have both Congressman DeFazio and Congressman Blumenauer, who I know would be here today if they could, working on that conference committee for a transportation bill that's good for our region, good for Oregon. So I want to thank Secretary of Transportation Ray LaHood, and I know the administrator will go back and tell him that we're so grateful for his work, and the transportation administrator here today, Administrator Rogoff, for their support of this region. And I know they do support this region. I've been in meetings where I've heard the Secretary LaHood talk about Oregon and the great work that they're doing here. And for recognizing that we really are a model for the nation for developing successful transit projects. Now, I've seen that success firsthand, and I'm glad Chair Dyke is here today as well, because light rail has made a tremendous difference to the west side and helped encourage nearby development, like Orenco Station, for example, while connecting people to jobs, schools, and other critical services. So congratulations again. A lot of partners came together to make this day possible. Thanks for everyone. I'm glad to be able to participate in making this step a reality. And I'm pleased to be working with you as we go forward as the next step in the metro area's transportation system. So thank you and congratulations.
Thank you so much, Congresswoman. We're so pleased to have you as one of our federal partners with this project and many others that we have in mind. So this is all about a signature. This is all about a commitment. And so I'd like to invite Congresswoman Bonamici and Administrator Rogoff over to our rather large sign here. And we'll begin the signing of the full funding grant agreement writ large here. You'll notice that the ink is orange, all in the theme of today. Yeah, right there. Mayor Adams, would you like to sort of get in line here? We'll move this along. And next we'll do Mayor Adams, and TriMet will sign. And if I could get Matt Garrett, Director of the Oregon Department of Transportation, and Carlotta Collette, Metro Councilor from the Milwaukee area. That's Clackamas County Chair Charlotte Lehan and Mayor Jeremy Ferguson of Milwaukee. Thank you all. With that done, let's get a quick picture. Oh. Next, we'd like to hear from some of our local partners who have contributed to this project. And first and foremost, Matt Garrett, Director of the Oregon Department of Transportation. Dr. Garrett.
Yeah. Well, good morning. I want you to know that the Oregon Department of Transportation is proud to be a partner on the Portland-Milwaukee Light Rail Project. With this project, we have much to celebrate. We celebrate another successful business transaction between the Federal Transit Administration, TriMet, and the regions. Congratulations, Administrator Rogoff, Mr. McFarland. We celebrate another successful partnership between the Department of Transportation and TriMet. Our folks work together on the design and the technical elements of this project. And simply put, we celebrate a project that will strengthen our multimodal transportation system, and in turn, the economic health of this region and the economic health of the state of Oregon. This project reminds us that those who have learned to collaborate, and improvise often prevail. So bottom line, let us continue to collaborate, let us continue to improvise, and let us prevail. Now, I would be remiss, because I'm a Southeast Portland boy, to give special thanks to the good folks of Southeast Portland and Milwaukee. I appreciate your patience. I appreciate the partnership, and maybe most importantly, I appreciate the perseverance that you have shown to deliver this project. These just don't happen, they're made to happen, and it's because of your leadership. Thank you very much. Now, it is with great pleasure that I introduced our next speaker. So let's give it up for Metro Councilor Carlotta Collette.
Thank you. Thank you, Matt. This is really an exciting day for many of us. I see a lot of faces in the crowd who've been working on this project for about a decade. But we have to keep remembering that we're not building a line here, we're building a system. And what's exciting about this is that we're connecting Milwaukee to the rest of a huge system of transit, of public ability to be able to get wherever you want without having to get into a car and drive in traffic. And that's really, really exciting to me. But another piece is that there's about $40 million in this project that will be for trails and for bike paths, and that connect up some of our more important bike commuter routes and sidewalks that people can get around on. So it's not just about trains, it's about being able to get around in a bunch of different ways without always having to drive your car in traffic. That's really, really an exciting part of this to me. And actually the most exciting part of this to me is that the last light rail station on this line is going to be the greenest light rail station in the country, because the community got together and designed a green light rail station for Park Avenue. It's going to be the best, and I'm really, really excited to see that happening. So thank you to all of you from the community. And now it is my pleasure to introduce our county chair, Ms. Charlotte Lehan.
Well, as many others have said, this is indeed an exciting time, an exciting day for Clackamas County and the rest of us who will participate in this project. I came a little bit late to this project, really just joined in the last few years, and before that I spent the last 10 years pretty much involved with a similar though different project on the west side, which is the West Project. And as Administrator Rogoff said, all the projects like this require a lot of partnerships at every level. And with Wes, it was Clackamas County and Washington County, and Senator Smith and Senator Wyden. It was very bipartisan. We could not have done it otherwise. And the same is true with this project. And I want to give, especially give credit or recognition at this point to the mayors of Milwaukee, Jim Bernard, who is currently county commissioner, and former Mayor Carolyn Tomei. The mayors of Milwaukee have really been working on this project for decades and moving it forward, and they have passed the ball and not given up on it, and they deserve a lot of credit for that. Of course, this project has not been without controversy in Clackamas County, but we are committed not only to being the best partners we can be, but also to addressing the concerns. We want this to be the greenest project. We want it to be the safest project, the quietest project, the best project we can build for Clackamas County and for the region, and we're committed to doing that. And with that, we will...
Thank you, Chair Lehan. Really appreciate that. Before we close, and we're just about there, I wanted to acknowledge our partner in the City of Milwaukee, Mayor Ferguson. He's relented, and you don't have to sit through another speech, so you really have something to thank him for. We now move the project into full construction, and we know that that can have some disruption about it, but we're committed to being the very best neighbor and the very best partner with our local neighborhoods that we could possibly be in doing this. Part of this is actually one of the interesting things you may see. You can't see it around this tent right now because we're so full of people, but it's something called the orange lining. And all of our orange-themed erosion control will have poetic words that have been contributed by members of the community, and that will line the various segments of the project. So even while we're building, we're going to show some art for everybody. Yeah. That's the Portland way. We're really pleased to do that. You might also want to know that this site, here in the Brooklyn neighborhood, we're working with them to create a future community garden. So something else we can look forward to seeing and riding by on the orange line in the future. I want to ask just finally that everybody who's working on the project, in one form or another, please raise your hand. Because we have an awful lot of Zoe, I see some of our Committee on Accessible Transportation members, you've all been working on the project. There is an enormous amount of effort that goes into these things, and I really want to thank you all for literally what's been a decade of work to get to this point. And for the next few years, I know you'll make us all look good with a really on time, on budget, very sensitive construction effort, and we're looking forward to that. I would be remiss if I didn't particularly thank members of the TriMet team that have brought us along, all under the direction of Dan Blocker, so thank you all for that great So thank you, Administrator Rogoff, our congressional delegation, all of our partners here, with the commitment from the federal government delivered today. This is a message to go full speed ahead. So let's get to work. Thank you all for coming.